So late last night, as soon as I got the news, I reported to you that I had found out that the reason that Wonder Woman 1984 has been pushed back a whole whopping 7 months is so that it can be restructured to be the new Flashpoint, aka to soft reboot the DCEU. That is the thesis statement of this whole video. Some of you took the news a little too literally. Oh, will Diana have the Speed Force? No, no, no. We're talking about a story that has Flashpoint elements enough so that that story can never be told now in the DCEU. But the bottom line is that it leads to a soft reboot, again, of the DCEU. Now, some of you voiced, I think, valid concern that this could end up being another hack job, a la Justice League and Suicide Squad, where a movie is reworked very late in the game for business reasons. But with the 7 month delay, that's a heck of a lot of time. And again, with this information, suddenly that makes a lot of sense, right? Whereas before, it certainly did not. But a 7 month delay to rewrite, you know, reshoot and have to, you know, basically start from scratch for a good chunk of the film, at least the third act, right? But I think with that amount of time, it's enough to do that, I think, effectively. And I think this is a good enough idea, an exciting idea, right? It made a lot of us feel a lot better all of a sudden, right? That it could work. But again, this is DC, so you never really know. Anyway, in the comments of that video, some of you also were like, Grace, what is this Flashpoint? And I'm sure that made a lot of Warner Brothers executives very happy. Because if you're not familiar with the classic Flash story, well, then you won't feel so bad when they give it to Wonder Woman, as some of you already do. So anyway, let's break it all the way down as to how exactly this would work. And if you weren't excited before, I think you will be by the end of this video. It's so fascinating to see everything suddenly click into place. I love it, Walter Hamada, I believe in you. All right, so Flashpoint is an iconic Flash story written by Geoff Johns. So you know he's made sure that every Warner Brothers executive knows about it, right? And in this story, Barry Allen stops his mother from being killed. He goes back in time using the Speed Force. And by the way, of course, she's also been killed in the DCEU. But by doing so, by saving her life, he creates an alternate timeline back to the future style, right? It's a big epic story, right? And, you know, there's so many elements to it that, you know, a lot of people really enjoy. But don't let that cloud how you're viewing this. Forget all that, right? Changing the timeline is what everyone has latched onto DCEU-wise. And I'm sure that's what Warner Brothers executives have latched onto, because such a story would allow considerable changes in the DCEU without having to recast everyone, right? But it's going to be mostly everyone from what I'm hearing. And then also without having to completely start over, which other franchises, like let's say Spider-Man, have tried in the past and it didn't really work out. And also you lose a lot of time having to do that, and they don't want to have to stop, like make a solid stop to restart. They want to change on the fly. And you know, alternate timeline stories allow you to do that. Now, just as many DCEU movies so far have been adaptations of Geoff Johns comics, right? The Flash movie was to share the same fate and be this Flashpoint story. Until Geoff Johns got Amy Pascal, aka fired from management and shifted to his own creative shingle, right? I hope it turns out as well for him as it has for Amy Pascal. He's basically right now in charge of the DC streaming service shows. And also, of course, he's supposedly working on a Green Lantern movie. We'll see if that ever comes to fruition. He's not particularly popular over there at the Warner Brothers movie offices right now. He and Snyder, unfortunately, which is weird, because they're not a pair by any means. Also Ezra Miller is overbooked with Fantastic Beasts movies, and that's caused his Flash movie to be pushed back to 2021. And as I said last night, that's way too long for Warner Brothers to wait to soft reboot the struggling DCEU. So considering, and again, all the pieces falling into place, considering the close proximity of the Flash and Wonder Woman headlines, it's clear that once Warner Brothers discovered it had to push the Flash movie back, they needed a new place to alter the timeline. And hey, doesn't Wonder Woman's story already take place in 1984? Aren't we already dealing with time travel? What if, instead of Barry saving his mother, Diana saves Steve Trevor, right? It's the same beats, the emotional beats. And you can see how a Hollywood creative exec would see it that way, even though it's blasphemy to some comic book fans. And they can do that thanks to, again, some reshoots and changes to the end, you know, the very least the third act, of Wonder Woman 1984. Now, these changes could take place literally in 1984, right? Although, because, you know, she could just find a way to keep him around because he does come back, right? You know, I've said that it's going to be Heaven Can Wait style where he's in someone else's body, but maybe she finds a way, makes some kind of deal with a god, right, as Wonder Woman so often does, to keep him around permanently. And that changes the timeline. But as some of you, I think, accurately pointed out, Bruce Wayne would already be alive at this time. They've cast a young Bruce Wayne in the Joker movie, which also takes place in the 1980s. Superman, Clark Kent, would already be on planet Earth. Although, of course, he's still going to come to planet Earth. He's just going to look, like a different actor. But as some of you also pointed out, with the gods in play, that certainly doesn't rule out her. This is where it starts to maybe travel into hack job territory. It's just going to be hard to pull off effectively. But Wonder Woman at the end of 1984 could go back to World War I, to the first movie, getting really Back to the Future-y. Although it was fun in Back to the Future, so again, I think this could work if they really stick to their, you know, creative guns and they work hard at it. And then she could go back to World War I at the end of the movie and save Steve there. Now, does he age or does he become immortal? If she wants to go full Captain America, I think he'll stay immortal because, again, she can make another deal with a god, right? It's very easy with Wonder Woman. Whatever it takes to keep Chris Pine in play. Us fans of Pine, and there are a lot of us, I think we'll be pretty lax in what we're willing to accept in terms of narrative here. And then also, some of you suggested, and I like this idea, maybe in the current time period, he could assist Amanda Waller with Suicide Squad as he has in the comics. I saw some people be like, why would Steve Trevor work with Amanda Waller with Suicide Squad? Ask DC Editorial. All I know, there's a precedent for it and it gives him something to do. So lucky you, James Gunn, you might get fan favorite Chris Pine. He should be lobbying for that as we speak. So just to reiterate, I don't believe the Flash will appear in the 1984 movie, Wonder Woman 1984, and this won't be the literal Flashpoint story, but it will be close enough that Warner Brothers can never make that movie, because they'll be like, oh, didn't we already do this with Wonder Woman, right? I mean, I guess Flash could run through time like he did in BVS and be the one to take Diana back to World War I, right? But that seems overly complicated. I kind of want to recast Ezra Miller. Nothing against him. I actually love Ezra Miller, but he just didn't turn out to be a great Flash. Now, taking away Flash's story could really upset some of you, and wiping away Snyder's universe could upset even more of you, which, by the way, I hear, again, is largely fueling this soft reboot, the desire to do away with the Snyderverse. Yes, by altering the timeline in the Wonder Woman 1984 movie, be it in 1984 or during World War I, Warner Brothers can recast whoever they'd like. And if any movie prior to Wonder Woman 84 doesn't do well at the box office, well, those actors better watch out. But get this. In the comic book story, Flash, as some of you also pointed out, and so I'm getting to this, Flash eventually puts the timeline back to the way it was. So this leaves the door open at a later date for Warner Brothers to do the same thing and bring back Henry Cavill, Ben Affleck, Jared Leto, etc., creating another big hype moment. That's a great card. You know, that's a great ace to have up your sleeve for a rainy day. And they got a lot of rainy days over there at Warner Brothers. I think this is great. I love it. Although, I'm not the purist that some of you are, because I like Batman v Superman, and it took a lot of liberties. But I think this sounds fantastic. Now, when I broke this news last night, I referenced the Thanos snap, and some of you brought up X-Men Days of Future Past. But yes, once again, we have to accept this, the DCEU will get hit with accusations of copying other franchises. But the difference here is that they will put the pedal to the metal. This will bring about real change. Like, you know, so often they're like, oh, we're changing things. And you're like, not really. They're going to have different actors playing these characters. They're going to change which characters are on which team. They could bring in totally new characters that they hadn't in the past. I think it's very exciting. And they don't have to do a bunch of origin stories. They just explain it away by Diana altered the timeline, and let's just hit the ground running, as Warner Brothers very much wants to do. They want to just keep moving. So suddenly, James Gunn's all-new Suicide Squad team makes perfect sense. Shazam just got ordered into reshoots itself, as many of you tweeted me last night, like maybe to incorporate some aspects here. Joaquin Phoenix's Joker could be part of this new timeline if they so choose. Matt Reeves' younger Batman suddenly is the new Batman, etc., etc. And finally, from what I'm hearing, this has lit a creative fire under Warner Brothers now that they have seen a way out of the restrictions of the old DCEU. Expect some big headlines coming very, very soon. There is a huge one percolating as we speak, but it's not far enough along or 100% confirmed for me to be able to report it. It's very interesting, though, and I'm sure I will be reporting it soon. Not like tomorrow, but I think soon. It's going to really, you know, a lot of you are going to be very excited. I can't say anything else. All right, so share your thoughts down below. And of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.